Yeah, it's about that time again.
WNLR New Level Radio. New Level Radio. WNLR New Level Radio. Live in the red, WNLR New Level Radio.
Welcome to WNLR New Level Radio. I'm your host, N.I.L.E, and we like to welcome you all back, you know what I mean, to our Celebrity Chaos episode series. And this Celebrity Chaos episode is episode number 5, you know what I mean? And we like to thank everybody here, you know, right now listening. We always like to open our show with, you could have been anywhere listening to any podcast that you wanted to, but you took the time to check us out, and we really appreciate that. No, we just don't take that for granted. And be sure you pass these podcasts around, you know what I'm saying? Just forward them to your friends on Facebook, you know what I mean? Because we want to really get the dialogue going and get these comments up, you know what I mean? But definitely, you know, we appreciate it. But let's get right into the Celebrity Chaos episode number 5, you know what I mean? And here's the thing. I was wondering, who could I do the actual Celebrity Chaos episode on? And I was talking to, you know, my man DJ Fella. Shout out to DJ Fella, New Level Entertainment, you know, president, DJ extraordinaire, you know. And I was talking to a couple people. And just recently, we actually had a parade for one of our Hall of Famers of the Baltimore Ravens, you know. So I said, let me go ahead and do the Celebrity Chaos episode number 5 on him. And that is no other than number 52, Mr. Ray Lewis. You know what I mean? And I had to do this because I'm a little, you know, I got mixed feelings about this. You know what I mean? But be clear, I'm from Baltimore, Raven till I die. You know what I mean? Bleed purple and black, you know. Here's the thing. Ray Lewis has been very, very, very influential and very, very, very much a pillar in the Baltimore community, okay? And I want to say that first off the bat. But there are a lot of people in Baltimore City who are diehard Raven fans who basically have an issue with Ray Lewis's stance on politics, okay? They feel like, hey, he's a wonderful football player. He was the pillar of the football team and everything. You know what I'm saying? He did stuff in the community. But when he tried to dab into politics a little bit, a lot of people was like, eh, I don't know. You know, Ray sound like Uncle Tom a little bit now. You know what I'm saying? But let me say this. One thing that I can say about Ray Lewis, okay, is that Ray Lewis, if anybody can talk and say stuff, you understand, it's Ray Lewis, period. He can say it because we all know that Ray Lewis has his own history. We know that. And in spite of his own history, he could have been a statistic like everybody else. And this is why I wanted to make the Celebrity Chaos episode number 5 about Ray Lewis, because he just not too long ago got honored, you know, into the Hall of Fame, okay, which is a big deal. And he also had a parade done for him in Baltimore, okay? Now, here's the thing. People were getting mixed opinions about, hey, I ain't going to the parade or nothing like that. And it was because of the Colin Kaepernick situation, okay? And this is really what kind of put Ray Lewis in the hot seat a little bit. For those of you who don't realize, Ray Lewis and Shannon Sharp, two NFL Baltimore Raven veterans. You understand what I mean? Very stand-up brothers. Both of them are very good friends. You understand my point? But for those of you who know Shannon Sharp, he's sharp. He definitely is, with his politics, with his stance on sports and everything. And he and Ray Lewis were on, I believe they were on ESPN one episode, and they were talking about the whole situation about, you know, Colin Kaepernick. You know what I mean? And here's what happened. Shannon Sharp spoke up about the Colin Kaepernick situation. And Ray Lewis was there on the panel, okay? So what happened was this, okay? Ray Lewis expressed his perspective about what the NFL should do. Now, this is what he said, okay? And you can, you know, relook at the news or the actual ESPN clip if you want to get the actual quote. But in a gist of what Ray Lewis was saying, I understood what he was saying in the context of the way he said it for the NFL. What Ray Lewis basically said was that the NFL doesn't have any responsibility to the social issues of like the community. That's what he said, in such a way that they are responsible for honoring the actual, you know, wishes or the social issues of Colin Kaepernick, you know, taking a knee. Okay. Basically, Ray Lewis was like, look, that's not the NFL's job. As far as the commissioners, they don't care about that. And Shannon Sharp disagreed. He said, nah, they're fans that go there every day, so they should. You understand? So because of that statement made by Ray, it was really taken as he was taking the side of the NFL. You understand? Not taking accountability for social issues in a nutshell. And clearly, personally, I know that's not what Ray Lewis was saying. He was basically saying that the NFL is a business. And if it's a business, that is not their business dynamic to deal with social issues. That is what Ray Lewis was saying on behalf of the NFL's perspective on why they really didn't get involved with the whole Colin Kaepernick situation. You know what I'm saying? Basically, there was a lot of backlash that came from that, okay, with Ray Lewis. Now, ever since then, people were kind of giving them a side eye. And keep in mind now, we know Ray Lewis was acquitted of murder charges, you understand what I mean, in 2000 and 2001. And he was acquitted of those charges, but be clear, before he was acquitted of those charges, okay, they locked him up. Ray Lewis did some time. You understand what I'm saying? He did like, you know, they locked him up. He was off the field. They locked him up. He got his lawyers and everything. He was in a jumpsuit. You understand what I mean? So he didn't just stay home until all this blew over. They locked him up and he got acquitted of these charges, went right back to playing football, ended up winning the Super Bowl. You understand what I'm saying? Beating the New York Giants 34-7. I never forget it because I saw that game and he was the MVP. Okay. And I can remember that the Wheaties box endorsement that people got for the MVP, they didn't give it to Ray Lewis. You understand? So Ray Lewis, even today, he is still getting backlash about people calling him a murderer. You understand what I mean? And this is why I wanted to bring this Celebrity Chaos episode up about Ray Lewis. You know? And I wanted to bring it up because he was acquitted of charges. Be clear. They didn't drop him or dismiss him, which basically is acquitted. He was acquitted of the charges. Okay? So, again, he was not guilty. He was in jail before the trial even started. They locked him up. Now, be clear. Again, you have to really look at this from the perspective of Ray Lewis. He did his time, okay? He could have very well stayed in jail. His career could have been over. Very well. Some people feel like it should have. But you know what? Ever since he was out and he was acquitted, Ray Lewis ain't getting no more trouble. Nothing, not remotely. Now, you can't say that for a lot of other NFL players. You can't say that at all. There were no domestic violence charges for him, nothing. Now, let me be clear, me bringing that up, okay? Domestic violence charges. Another prominent young man who unfortunately took a fall, you understand, was number 27, Ray Rice. You know, shout out to Ray Rice. Mind you, Ray Rice was, you know, blackballed from the NFL because of domestic violence charges, okay? Again, Ray Lewis and his fiance or wife, however you want to say it, Ray Lewis was there for actual Ray Rice, okay? Gave him a few words and stuff like that. You understand what I mean? But Ray Rice was squeaky clean. Nothing. He ain't had no issues. He had a lot of endorsements for kids, did a lot in Baltimore City. But it took one incident that happened. And here's the crazy part. Ray Rice owned up to it. Okay? He owned up to it. We're talking about Ray Rice now, and we're still staying on the topic of Ray Lewis. We're talking about Ray Rice. He owned up to his situation. And Ray Rice's wife, his fiance, she even spoke publicly and said, it was my fault. This is what happened. And the funny thing is, she spoke publicly, okay? She didn't try to file charges or hide and come out the woodwork. Nah, she admitted. She spit in Ray Rice's face. Apparently, she was drunk. You understand what I'm saying? Of course, that hit and that tape that came out, it was sold by the hotel security, okay? So somebody got it. But the bottom line with Ray Lewis that I'm talking about is this. None of that happened with Ray. You understand my point? None of that happened with Ray. And even when Ray was acquitted of all charges, people are still carrying that over his head because they say, hey, somebody's dead. Somebody's dead. You have NFL players who have not only beat their wives, who've been, you know, alleged of sexual, you know, assault, but some of them even did a murder. You understand my point? And they didn't get acquitted because they were charged. But my bottom line is I wanted to make sure I did this episode number 5 of the Celebrity Chaos episode about Ray Lewis, because Ray Lewis is now a NFL Hall of Famer. He actually had a parade for him in Baltimore City, okay? And he still speaks out socially about things he wants to do to help the city. He does. He still even goes to the football team now and supports them, okay? But it's just kind of ironic how people can quote-unquote make mistakes. And let's be clear, Ray Lewis didn't make a mistake. Ray Lewis was just in a bad situation in the wrong place at the wrong time, around the wrong people, okay? Your actual mistakes or even just mishaps of being in the wrong place at the wrong time, it's unfortunate how people are just so unwilling to actually forgive and let people live. That's crazy, you know? And like I said, going back to the Ray Rice incident, okay? Ray Rice and his wife were together, okay? They're still together, I'm sure. He tried to get a spot back in the NFL after everything blew over, but nobody wanted to take a chance on him. You understand my point? And this is the crazy part. They still have NFL players like, again, Roethlisberger. Clearly, there were allegations of rape against him. Roethlisberger, you understand? Quarterback, Pittsburgh Steelers. You know what I mean? So it's just crazy how there is always this imbalance of selection and how people want to actually co-sign one person, but then they want to crucify another. And I'm not going to make this a black and white issue because specifically this ain't a black and white issue. Not here. It could be, but that's not the case because I am making a point about Ray Lewis. Okay. He's an NFL Hall of Famer. Okay. He is an MVP. He's a Super Bowl champion twice. He was the pillar of the Baltimore Ravens. You understand that? He was accused of a murder charge. Listen, he was charged and he was locked up in a jumpsuit. He wasn't convicted. He was charged in a jumpsuit locked up. And even then, when he missed time from the NFL, you know what? His charges were acquitted. He was acquitted of all charges. Went to the Super Bowl and won. Now, I know that that is not the American dream that most people believe that somebody like Ray Lewis should have the story of. You understand my point? A tragedy to triumph, you know? And that is why I really chose to do this Celebrity Chaos episode, because Ray Lewis is not the only one who has this, you know, tragedy to triumph story. You understand what I mean? You think about Michael Vick, Okay? Michael Vick, dog fighting. Oh, we're not even going to go there. Okay? Michael Vick wasn't even around. But the one thing that we can definitely say is that Michael Vick was one person that they actually took down because they felt like he was cocky. He was just who he was. They took him down. Michael Vick did jail time for killing dogs. You understand what I'm saying? And here's my problem. You can go to jail for killing dogs, a year in prison, but if you murder somebody, maybe whoever it is, African American, whatever, you understand my point? You can do less time killing a human being, but do more time killing dogs. See, that lets us know how twisted our society is. You understand? Animals have more rights than individuals do. And people think that that's okay. People think that God is okay with that. But I say all that to say that somebody like Ray Lewis, you understand my point? He was the very person who could talk to Michael Vick. He tried to get Michael Vick, you know, recruited to the Ravens when nobody would take Michael Vick. And here's the funny thing. After Michael Vick did his time and nobody would take him, it was just like Ray Rice. You understand my point? Ray Rice couldn't get a spot in the NFL. Michael Vick couldn't get a spot in the NFL. And think about Colin Kaepernick. He couldn't get a spot in the NFL. And even with Colin Kaepernick didn't commit any crime whatsoever. So I look at the narrative of all these things, okay? You have Ray Lewis, who was acquitted, who this episode number 5 is about, the Celebrity Chaos episode. He was acquitted of murder. People still holding that over his head after a decade later. Ray Rice, you understand? Before that, Ray Rice was on tape with actual domestic violence, domestic assault of his fiance. His fiance admitted what she did. Do you understand my point? And even though Ray Rice didn't do no jail time, you understand my point? His career got demolished because of it, okay? His wife even spoke out. His fiance, his wife, she was on the news and said that, look, it was my fault. You understand? I spit in his face. I did something wrong to him. You understand? And you had domestic violence organizations trying to speak for her when she was in front of a camera speaking for herself. See, that's the problem that we have. You have people that can speak for themselves, and then you have other organizations like the domestic violence organizations. They say, hey, she's just distraught. How are you going to say a woman is distraught and she's in front of a camera defending the man that she loves? Okay? That's crazy. Both of them went to counseling. That was for their issue to work out. She even said publicly, me and my husband just want to work this situation out. You understand what I mean? We just want to work it out. Now, be clear. Ray Rice never had an issue. Never. Now, here's the thing. Go from Ray Lewis to Ray Rice. Now go to Michael Vick. Okay? Michael Vick did dog fighting. They made an example of him because animal rights activists are very powerful politically. Okay? Just like domestic violence organizations are very powerful political. Okay? And for good reason. Animals need rights. Women need rights. Everybody needs rights. Okay? Now, Michael Vick did jail time a year, okay? He couldn't even get an actual NFL job. Nobody wanted him until Ray Lewis talked the Baltimore Ravens into giving him a shot. And it wasn't until then they were considering bringing him to Baltimore as a quarterback before Joe Flacco. You understand what I'm saying? Guess what? Everybody started wanting Michael Vick. They weren't paying them much, but they were giving him a chance, okay? Now, fast forward to Colin Kaepernick, okay? We're still talking about Ray Lewis now, but we're looking at the trend here. Colin Kaepernick didn't commit any crime whatsoever, none. He took a knee for social injustice that blatantly happened in the city of everywhere. Philando Castile, Sandra Bland, Michael Brown, Trayvon Martin. You understand? All of these individuals he was protesting for by taking a knee peacefully. You understand? And guess what? This man got totally blackballed from the NFL. Totally blackballed, right? So I guess the pattern of all of them, they got something wrong with them. You see what I mean? But I can give you other NFL players who have blatantly got records and done stuff wrong, and they have the Caucasian nature, or they other black players. You understand what I mean? It's a whole different narrative then. But going back to Ray Lewis, the bottom line is Ray Lewis is the only one who actually came out on top after all of the tragedy out of all of them. You understand my point? With the exception of Colin Kaepernick, because Colin Kaepernick sacrificed his career and God bless him, he came out on top and Nike gave him an endorsement deal strictly on his social position of injustice against police brutality against African Americans and other minorities, okay? But Ray Lewis, he is a Hall of Famer, okay? His number is retired. They gave him a parade, you know? But Ray Lewis's social comments, people don't agree with him. But I just feel like at least he's speaking up. He's trying to be as conscious as he can be. He's trying to do the right thing. He always has. He's always been a stand-up guy. So shout out to Ray Lewis, number 52. I got your jersey. You know what I mean? And again, I wanted to make sure that I did this Celebrity Chaos episode on Ray Lewis, because Ray Lewis is the very, 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 very pinnacle of the type of NFL player who's gone through what he's gone through that they never expected to actually get to the end of the rainbow, which is to be a Hall of Famer. You understand that? That's a beautiful thing. Two Super Bowl rings, retired, Hall of Famer. You understand? And people are still giving him controversy. You understand? So I just want you all to kind of leave your comments on that. Let me know what your perspective is. You know what I mean? The facts are the facts. I'm all about Ray Lewis, number 52. Congratulations. And just to point out to people in Baltimore when that parade happened, here's the thing. A lot of individuals who probably didn't attend the parade, this is why they didn't attend. Some people didn't attend because of Ray Lewis, because of their position. But mainly, it was because of the mayor, Mayor Catherine Pugh. Okay? They were upset that they could throw Ray Lewis a parade when on the first day of school, there were at least 12 to 13 schools in the city of Baltimore that didn't have air conditioning. You understand what I mean? And they had to delay and let kids out early of school on the first day of school. So a lot of people were going in on the mayor like, how you gonna have money to throw Ray Lewis a parade, but you don't have money to put in our schools for air conditioning? So for all of the people in the media who think that this is about Ray Lewis and the parade, nah, it's really about the mayor and the quote unquote displacement of priority as far as the city goes. The children and the kids of Baltimore City and the schools need funding. You know what I mean? Everybody passes the buck, but guess what? Ray Lewis, you know, he's done community work. He's still doing community work. He's doing community work for the kids of Baltimore. He has programs that are already in the city. The problem is that he's not the mayor. You know, he can only do what he can. But that's what the real controversy was about when it came to the parade that they gave Ray Lewis. It was like, how are you going to have money to give Ray Lewis a parade, but you don't have money to give the schools their actual funding to just get air conditioning? You understand what I'm saying? So that's what that controversy was about. Not to mention the fact that they recently built a $1 million juvenile detention center. You understand what I mean? Which sends a actual subliminal message to a lot of people in Baltimore City. If you're spending $1 million on a juvenile detention center, you found that money someplace. You place that money in a juvenile detention center as opposed to putting it in schools that are already underfunded, okay? And this is why when we hear things about Ray Lewis and all of the narrative about, hey, he Uncle Tom and stuff like that, you never know what's going on behind closed doors. And again, I'm not bashing the mayor, Catherine Pugh. Shout out to Catherine Pugh. Hey, you got the city when it was a mess. And like I said, the previous mayor, couldn't handle it. You know what I mean? And it was just one of those situations where the city's got to come together. Baltimore, you know, I'm from Baltimore. And again, I believe that the mayor did the parade because in her eyes, she felt like it would be a glimmer of light in all the tragedy that's going on in Baltimore City and all of the things that are going on with the schools not having money and all the transitions with the, you know, the new governor trying to be governor and all the voting and all of the, you know, politics that are taking place. Something has to be a stable pillar of hope for the city. And I know that's probably why she did the parade for Ray Lewis. Because Ray Lewis does have a voice that's influential in the city of Baltimore. So again, that's why I wanted to do this actual episode number 5, you know, of Celebrity Chaos episode on the NFL Hall of Famer number 52, Ray Lewis. So please leave your comments, you know what I mean, on this episode. And as I said, I thank y'all very much for tuning in. You could have been anywhere else listening to any podcast or anything, but you took the time to listen to us here at WNLR New Level Radio. And we thank y'all. God bless. Peace out.
WNLR New Level Radio.